Setagaya Literary Museum was established by the city of Setagaya in 1995. And the number of annual visitors is about 138,000. Setagaya Ward is located about 20 minutes by train from central Tokyo, and it's the most populous municipality in the Tokyo metropolitan area. Current population is about 872,000. Setagaya Ward was developed as a suburban residential district in the 1920s, and many artists and writers had also moved to Setagaya to get a spacious atelier and good living environment since 1920s. And one major film companies, Toho, has a studio in Setagaya. Toho Studios has given birth to many of Japan's representative films, from most of Akira Kurosawa's works, including The Seven Samurai and giant monster films such as Godzilla. As you see, there are huge murals of The Seven Samurai and Godzilla in front of the studio main gate. And Seijo District, where studio located, has historically attracted many movie directors and actors, including Akira Kurosawa, Kon Ichikawa, and Toshiro Mifune. And today, many celebrities is living in Seijo District. So today, it's known as an upscale neighborhood. So, in a way, Setagaya has been the site of wide range of creative activities. Against this cultural historical background, it's our job to explore the true merits of the work done by literary and film figures with links to Setagaya and to convey them far beyond the local area. By the way, there is a Setagaya Art Museum at a distance from the Literary Museum. It was established in 1986 before the Literary Museum opened. So now we cover various genres of the arts by the two museums. The Literary Museum is housing over 90,000 items, such as original manuscripts, letters, rare books, and so on, related to literary figures working in a variety of genres, including mystery, science fiction, juvenile fiction, travel writing, poetry, and so on. And the collection also includes film scripts, set sketches, still photographs, and a few movie props. This is one of the biggest items. This Godzilla was actually used for filming Godzilla Millennium in 1999. It goes without saying that our facility is a museum rather than a library. So we have adapted catchphrase spaces to experience literature. The mission is to create a place that will provide encounters and encourage interest in diverse literary works, prompt the rediscovery of cultural history in Setagaya Ward, and facilitate meetings and exchanges between people via literature. So, in addition to conducting research, we focus primarily on organizing exhibitions and public programs targeting a wide range of ages. But, in general, visitors of literary museums tend to be middle-aged book lovers with developed intellectual curiosity. So, we have adapted two distinctive programs to help broaden the range of visitors and increase the appeal of literature. The first, cross-genre exhibition, focuses on the relationship between literature and other artistic genres, such as art, design, film, a drama, music, and manga. It has remained a key part of our activities since the facility opened 19 years ago. We hope that cross-genre exhibitions prompt the people who don't have much interest in literature to come to the museum and find the literary aspects of the subjects. The second, the Children's Museum of Literature, targets children from the age of 6 to 15. The Children's Museum of Literature is not the name of a facility, but rather a series of programs organized for children. A variety of activities, including exhibition-related workshops, worksheets, and outreach programs using replicas of the collection, are held throughout the year. And next, I'd like to introduce three typical examples of cross-genre exhibition. The first, the Osamu Tezuka retrospective, features the work of the king of manga, Osamu Tezuka, who laid the foundation of contemporary Japanese comics and animation, and is well known for the world-famous Astro Boy. Although there have been numerous manga exhibitions in recent years in Japan, this event focused on the literary aspects of the manga and Osamu Tezuka works by outlining the story and social context. So the exhibits were not only original pictures, but also many phrases quoted from the works and many and various materials for creating the works. As manga is familiar to large audience, including everyone, from children to adults, exhibitions related to manga tend to be blockbusters. This event was similarly popular, attracting the second largest number of visitors to a special exhibition in the museum's history. And many notable manga artists have been residents of Setagaya, so we are planning to revisit manga in a future exhibition. Second, the Sage Horiuchi Designs, Journeys, and Picture Books exhibition surveys the career of Sage Horiuchi, a Setagaya resident artist who revolutionized editorial design in the Japanese magazine world as a designer, created a number of best-selling picture books as an illustrator, and traveled all over the world as an essayist. By comprehensively introducing Horiuchi's multifaceted activities, this event stressed the links between different genres and highlighted the artist's collaboration with various literary figures. This event was warmly received by those in the art and design fields, especially young people. So the year after it was presented at the Setagaya Literary Museum, it traveled to four other art museums in Japan. Third, the expansion of the metropolis, Tokyo in the 1930s exhibition, was jointly organized with the Setagaya Art Museum. Dividing the works from the two facilities into the categories of literature, painting, sculpture, photographs, prints, music, film, advertisements, and housing. This event presented an overview of the cultural environment in the suburb of Tokyo in the 1930s. This event let us introduce the works from the collections that had not often been shown in the past. But the academic theme and overly broad range of content detracted from our overall appeal, ultimately attracting only one third number of visitors at the Osamu Tezuka show. But on the other hand, this event let the curators show and summarize their daily efforts, the results of their daily efforts in catalog. It was a significant undertaking. And next, I'd like to present World Museum and Literary Walk, which are notable programs of the Children's Museum of Literature. World Museum was launched in 2009 and is a series of workshops that is held inside the museum. In the first half of our series, participants experience three workshops called Words and the Body, Words and Gesture, Words and Art, which deal with subjects that bridge literature and other genres. And through these workshops, participants experience non-verbal method of communication through artistic and physical expressions. And these workshops followed by two activities called Words of Words 1 and 2, in which participants create a linguistic expressions or poems dealing with the same, the self. In each workshop, artists working in a variety of genres serve as a facilitator, and a workshop takes place once a month, so it takes 5 or 6 months to complete a total of 5 workshops. And next, literary work was launched in 2011 and is a program that is conducted outdoors, dealing with subjects such as Setagaya folktales, short story, and juvenile fiction related to the museum's exhibition or the collection. We organized outings, not only to local destinations, but also to mountains or rivers outside the Tokyo metropolitan area. Led by nature observers or artists, participants visit the places that are depicted in literature, and sometimes take part in cooking projects or craft projects along the way. We usually take train or bus to site for activity and walk a distance of from 7 to 10 kilometers. So it requires from 7 to 9 hours in all. It's a highly demanding program. But many children participate on a regular basis. In order to meet more specific needs, last year we introduced beginner's course for 5 to 12 year olds and intermediate course for 9 to 15 year olds. And next, I'd like to show you a short movie of a literary work. This work theme was Godo Nakanishi, who was a Setagaya resident poet and was also an ecologist. So we went to Takao, where Godo Nakanishi had observed nature very often. both World Museum and Literary Walk emerged from the desire to motivate children to engage in creative activities and to provide place that would inspire them to write and convey information. To prompt children's interest in expressing themselves, it is first necessary to provide them with unique experience and emotional stimulation. Moreover, many young people today do not have the opportunity to play with children of different ages. In that sense, these activities are also important means of creating diverse human relationships outside the classroom environment. All of our activities share the common goal of creating a museum that allows people to experience literature. Our exhibitions, workshops, and walks are intended to go beyond merely reading and listening, and serve as a mechanism to encourage people feel and consider literature through physical spaces and their bodies. Acclaimed for our efforts to expand the potential of Literary Museum, we received Japan Foundation for Regional Art Activities Award 2013. Literary Museum is not a term that appears in most Japanese dictionaries, which is to say, there is no clear definition. This makes it even more important to devise new functions and continue making use of them, while engaging in trial and error process, we hope to create a new style of literary museum in the future. Thank you for your kind attention.